and welcome to a fresh edition of Government House Berry on NTA Kano. The program highlights the weekly engagement of His Excellency, the Executive Governor of Kano State, Engineer Rabi Musa Konkosu, and special assignments performed on his behalf by top government officials. I am Samira Hamisishura, your regular guide. The Nigerian Red Cross Society is a well-known humanitarian organization which services have been impacting positively on the lives of citizens, especially in emergency situations. In appreciation of Governor Rabi Musa Konkosu's commitments towards ensuring effective disaster and emergency management, the organization appointed him her patron. While thanking the Red Cross Society for the honor, he assured of renewed commitment of his government to partner with the organization.
We know you have it at heart. Okasia means supporting the needy, those who are weak, children, women, the sick, the poor, and so on and so forth. And I believe that is the position of members of Red Cross Society across the world. So I'm not surprised that they are putting this red cap. I'm not surprised that you didn't see any color cross, but red cross. Again, should automatically be members of the Red Cross Investiture. Let me assure you that supporting means the support, especially here in Government House, and of course what even happened on the 20th of January here in the States. So let me take this opportunity to thank you for all what you have done to save lives and properties here in Kano. Let me also say that some issues of plots and assistance and so on. I want you to put that on paper and bring it to us through the Commissioner for Health, and we'll look at it and see how best we can support you. Once again, you are welcome to Kano, those of you who came, those of you who are here with us, all of you, I want to assure you that your state government, our state government, will be very happy to partner with you to ensure that there is peace in Kano, and where we have to have emergencies, we'll work together with you to ensure that what is supposed to be done is done. Thank you very much for coming, and I wish you journey mercies.
The leader of the delegation had earlier told Governor Konkosu that the visit was to identify with his government and convey their sympathy over some unfortunate developments in the state.
Apology of your brother, the president of the Nigerian Red Cross Society, His Excellency Owele Anayo Rogers Okorocha, for his inability to be personally here today. I also, on behalf of the management, governors, members and volunteers of Nigeria's first and foremost responder, Nigerian Red Cross Society, commiserate with the people and government of Kano State, particularly over the unfortunate incident of Friday, 20th January 2012, and all other incidences thereafter. Her Excellency, the Nigerian Red Cross Society was established in 1960 by an Act of Parliament. Section 5 thereof provides that the society shall be recognized by the government of the Federation as a voluntary aid society auxiliary to the public authorities. This shows that the Nigerian Red Cross Society is a creation of the federal government of Nigeria and is empowered to augment public authorities in the area of humanitarian intervention. Our mandate is therefore derived from the said Act of Parliament and the Geneva Conventions to which Nigeria is a signatory. Our strength lies in our geographical spread and professionalism in the areas of emergency preparedness and response and disaster and risk reduction. with over 350,000 well-trained volunteers spanning all the states of the Federation and Federal Capital Territory, the Nigerian Red Cross Society has always turned out to be the sure hope of hope during emergencies. We shall offer that service and subsidize your action. We are happy to report to you, Your Excellency, that Elijah Aliko Dangote, a great son of Kano, and indeed a great Nigerian, has made a donation of 45 million naira to the Nigerian Red Cross Society towards building a clinic in Kano to be named after his mother, Hajia Maria. So tonight, this laudable gesture, we wish to request Your Excellency to kindly provide a suitable land for the building of this clinic. We recall with nostalgia similar donations made to the Nigerian Red Cross Society by Chief Remy Babalola, an Ibadan-based Red Cross benefactor, and Chief Tunde Lemo, an Abeokuta-based Red Cross benefactor, for the construction of similar clinics. These clinics have been completed with the assistance of Oyo and Ogun state governments, respectively, who provided the lands for these projects. Your Excellency, during disasters, mobility is of primary importance both to the victims and to those assisting national vehicles for the Kano branch of the Nigerian Red Cross Society. We humbly request for the assistance of your government in the provisions of ambulances and other operational vehicles, and in the two non-profit organizations such as the Nigerian. To this end, we humbly solicit for a monthly or annual subvention from Kano state government to our Kano branch, in welfare assistance to pilgrims during annual pilgrimage Hajj welfare committee. Well, Your Excellency, by law, the President of the with their kind permission, we will have the honor and privilege to formally invest you as the Kano state patron of the Nigerian Red Cross Society in the glory of the Almighty Allah and for the benefit of
polio eradication is one of the major health issues the administration of Governor Rabiu Musa Kwankwaso has been working assiduously to address since inception in May 2011. This effort is no doubt yielding positive results, as no single case of polio is recorded in the state from January to date. The state deputy governor, Dr. Abdullahi Umar Ganduji, had in an interview with NTA Kano's health correspondent Hadiza Muhammad said, in spite of this development, the government is not resting on its oars.
The issue of polio eradication in Kano state is a very, very serious issue, and government has taken it seriously as well. First thing what we have done is change of attitude. That is attitudinal change in the processes involved for the eradication of polio in Kano state. That is, first of all, we ensure that there's adequate finance for the programs to be implemented. And also we ensure that the funds to be provided are provided on time. So all those involved will get their allowances, and the places that we buy are bought in time, so that the children that we entice with some gifts and the women, they get it appropriately. Another change of attitude is the capacity building. We ensure that all those who are technically involved in the immunization are literate people, mostly graduates of health institutions like School of Nursing, School of Health Technology, midwifery, and such graduates from health institutions are involved, so that people who really know what it takes to do this kind of assignment are involved, instead of taking people along the street to go and execute something wrongly. Another issue is that of public enlightenment. We ensure that we use the local language, we use the radio, the television, and the stakeholders, all what it takes for people to know that polio is a very, very serious disease, and it is affecting the population, the economic development, the health of the population, and so. So we have increased the tempo of public enlightenment. Of course, the other one is the enforcement aspect. The efforts we have put, because we have invigorated the whole system, there is positive development because people are responding to it. And we have succeeded in involving all stakeholders, like top civil servants, politicians, retired civil servants, retired military, police, and business community, the traditional institution. All those people who are stakeholders in the communities are involved, and you find that all hands are in deck. So I think there is positive development towards that direction. Well, the Honorable Commissioner of Health will provide you with accurate figures and percentages so that I don't give you information which is not actually on the ground. So that one will be provided to you. But what I would like, we go directly to those areas. And also we succeeded in involving the law enforcement agents, especially the police women. And then the HISBA, which is an organization that is established in order to correct the ills of the society. So we use the female HISBA group. And you know, according to our tradition and culture and religion here, men are not allowed to go into houses unless they are members of the family or they are given special permission. So you find that our hands are tied, we cannot go inside the houses. So we use the police women and we use the HISBA women to enter into the houses. And also we use NGOs, women, the members of the NGO who are women, we use them to enter the houses. And you find that they check all corners of the houses. In fact, you will be surprised, some children are being hidden under the beds. So these women, they are able to go and bring them out for immunization. And also another issue we use, if we have any strong resistance, we arrest the head of the household, because we go about with the divisional police officer and his policemen, and anybody who does not cooperate, we order for his lockup, and he will not be released until his children are immunized. So by so doing, especially by getting accurate records of the non-compliance household, we are able to follow house to house to ensure that they are immunized. We received vaccine 6,888,000 doses, and we used 6,833,320. The number of children immunized is 6,486,370, and the total immunization coverage is 94.2%. So you see that the coverage has greatly increased, and we assure you that we are heading for 100% coverage within this month. Already we have started making arrangements for the immunization for March 2012. I'd like to make use of this medium to thank the people of Kano State, especially heads of households, for cooperating with the immunization teams in Kano. And I would like to make a special appeal that the Kano State government, under the leadership of Dr. Rabi Musa Konkoso, has promised to eradicate polio in Kano State forever with these new efforts that we are putting on the place. So I'm appealing to the members of the public to to cooperate, to continue cooperating with us. Those who are involved in non-compliance, we appeal to them to comply fully so that we can eradicate this disease from this part of the country. I think that is very important.
Hajia Aisha Abdul Qadir, who is the coordinator of state immunization program, also speak on challenges and efforts being made to win the war against polio in Kano.
To be candid, we have a lot of preparedness between at our state level, because now what we observe, we have a lot of innovations that we have implemented now, new innovations towards this polio eradication. Because if you understand the situation of Kano now, the state has a very good interest of taking part to eradicate this polio disease in the state. So our level of preparedness now, already our vaccines are available from the national store. And then almost the training is going to be done at all levels, that is through our state technical facilities and the local immunization offices at all levels. And also all higher state delegation posted, we are planning to post it earlier, because the executive governor of Kano State said that the state is very interested in taking part of all this activity to kick away polio. So we will notify them early to tell them where to be fostered as a special higher delegation team. And also the state supervision team is now compiling. We are compiling the names of the state supervision team offices. And at the same time, now through our special innovations, we have invited a lot of nomadic as for us to reach our main migrants and the hard rich areas of the next round.
Away from health issues, Kano State Government says it will complete all meaningful projects that were abandoned by the past administration. Commissioner of Works, Housing and Transport, Alhaji Abubakar Yusuf, stated this during an assessment visit to the site of the abandoned International Conference Center within the premises of Audubakar Secretariat. He, at the moment, directed the contractor to return to site.
Now, let me say that government is committed to completing all ongoing projects all over the state. We are said we are going to support you, and I believe as soon as we are able to settle our own obligations, you should mobilize back to
site. Of course.
We don't want wasted time,
and
we don't want inferior or substandard constructions. So whatever you are going to do to mobilize back to site, should do it, you should start it now.
Okay.
We are going to support you.
Okay.
We don't see any reason why you should abandon the site despite all the support the government gives you. That excuse of non-payment of valuation certificate to us is not an excuse. You have the capacity, you have the capability to do it. So mobilize back to site and continue with your project.
Okay.
As soon as possible, we will see what you do.
Okay.
You can see this is so dear to the state government.
Yes.
It's going to alleviate a lot of sufferings for our teeming population, our youths, coming for conferences and other seminars and so on. So we want you to, as soon as possible, mobilize back to site and be able to complete. And so far from what I have seen, I have seen a very qualitative job.
Thank
and
you.
I have seen at least you have reached 60% of the completion list, and with the government is happy. And we want you to help the government, help the state by mobilizing back to site. Thank you.
Still in the Works Ministry, the Commissioner Abubakar Yusuf has inaugurated a committee for the reorganization of state road traffic departments. He said the move was part of the government's determination to improve the standards of its management and services.
Very much concerned about the rate of accidents and death that has been occurring in most of our major roads, particularly the interstate roads. And based on that, the government came up with a decision that we need to have a scheme that will be able to take care of the passengers, accident victims, and per se even victims of death. Based on that, we gave permission to Kano Line to invite reputable companies, reputable health insurance schemes, and negotiate with them. Alhamdulillah, today I'm happy that your company has been selected with this laudable objective. I wish to congratulate you on this. And as the MD has said, they have categorized the rate of benefits for victims of maybe for injured ones. God forbid, we are not hoping. As for death, you know, what is intended is for the family to have a benefit after the change of 200,000. This is something that has never happened in Kano State. I was made to understand that one or two states have already taken the initiative. We are not copying them per se because we didn't even know they have done it until now. This is our own initiative, our own idea. And I congratulate you, I congratulate Kano Line, and I congratulate all the Kano State people.
The seven-member committee, which has 2 weeks to submit its report, is headed by Alhaji Musa Ibrahim Khalil. This is where we'll draw the curtain of Government House Dairy for now. Keep it a date with NTA Kano next Monday for another interesting package. Before then, I am Samira Hamizishira, saying God bless Kano State and goodbye.